Hello everyone. Today, let's discuss about feeding problems in children. This is something which we often come across when we are evaluating a child for their speech and language development or a development in whole. We often see parents who shares with us that my child can eat vegetables but only in a semi-solid form. Is it okay if my child eats only potato and dal rice? Or do we need to really give apple as a fruit form? Isn't it the same if we give it in a juice form or in a pureed form? These are some type of common questions which we often see in our regular OPs. Firstly, all the parents should understand that as per statistics, there are around 20-30% of normally developing children who ends up in having some form of feeding difficulties. And if you look into the statistics for children who have developmental issues, it raises up to 70-80% of a developmentally disordered children ends up in having certain degree or severity of feeding issues. Firstly, I want to understand that when we talk about feeding issues, it need not be a severe swallowing difficulty where the child often vomits or where the child often coughs. It could be a simpler or a milder version of feeding issues like the picky eating habits of the child or the behavioral aversions to the food. Often we see children who just closes their mouth in order to refuse the food, or they trying to give an excessive cry for telling the parents to stop, I'm enough, don't feed me more, don't push me more, isn't it? So basically, these all problems the child exhibits needs to be looked into very carefully. We need to evaluate what exactly is happening. Why the child is eating only the pureed forms? Why he is not unable to accept if the same fruit is given in a piece form or a solid form? Okay. So when we try dwelling into that, we generally end up diagnosing them as having issues at three different levels for feeding. The first level is called oromotor level, second one is orosensory, and the third one is called behavioral aversions to the food or the behavioral issues which are related to food. When we say it's oromotor, this is something related to rate and range of muscles involved in chewing food or involved in eating. To see peripherally, children might have no structural problem. I mean to say their lips would be normal, their palate would be normal, their dentition could be normal. But when I say about the rate and range, I mean to say how well the tongue is moving, with what speed and what range is it moving. That is more important, right? So all these fine movements and the rate of movements comes under the oromotor level of feeding issues. If there is anything related to that, definitely we need to work on with the oral exercises so that first we have to increase the strength of the muscles and then work on the feeding. And second one, as I said, is orosensory. It might be related to taste of the food, temperature of the food, color of the food and texture of the food. We see many children who might prefer eating chips. They can eat chips very well, they'll bite well, they'll chew well, but they might not show the same level of muscular movements when it comes to the rice items or when you introduce a vegetable to them. These children might prefer eating only the semi-solid form of your rice and the vegetables rather than eating it as a regular form which as adults we eat. Okay. And there is something called behavioral aversions to the food. Aversions is nothing but they might have attributed a negative attitude towards the food. The moment the child sees the food, they might close their mouth or they might run away. They'll show some hesitant behaviors towards it. So when treating a child for feeding issues or when diagnosing a child, whether the child really needs support from a professional feeding therapist or is it okay to try or just leave him like that? You definitely need to understand the child from these three different perspectives, your oromotor, orosensory and the behavior. So this will help us in order to treat the child or in order to provide appropriate tips for the parents which they can follow at home. So as parents, please never neglect any feeding issues in the child. Ultimately, we all need our children to have a good amount of nutrition. And how does this nutrition come? This comes only through a balanced diet. So in order to get a balanced diet, our children has to definitely learn to try new food items and to eat them as a wholesome pieces, not in just a pureed forms. Okay? Thank you so much. We'll look at about the swallowing issues in a different video. So I hope you understood that feeding and swallowing are little different from each other. Today we discussed only about feeding. If you want to understand more about the swallowing, please wait for the next week. Thank you.